Hey guys, what's up? Today, I want to make a video about the Scarlet Crusade. I mentioned a while back in my top 5 vanilla instances video and said that I was going to eventually make a video about the lore of the Scarlet Monastery and all that, but I figured I'd just do a lore video of the Scarlet Crusade altogether. So let's get rolling. Okay, so the Scarlet Crusade was created when Lordaeron fell. Almost immediately after the Knights of the Silver Hand were basically destroyed by the Scourge. The leaders who created the Scarlet Crusade were a little bit psycho, but a lot of the soldiers who joined their ranks just wanted to free Lordaeron from the Scourge, and basically wanted to destroy the Forsaken altogether. And that seems pretty understandable since the Scourge destroyed their home, which at that time was one of the most powerful kingdoms in the Eastern Kingdoms. Some of the founders were Sadon Dathrohan, High Lord Mograin, Isilion, and Abendus. Some of these founders had pure intentions. Some of their sanities slowly slipped from them as time went on, and some were completely insane right from the beginning. Isilion. Abendus was able to persuade people to join their ranks by using fear of the Scourge as a recruitment tactic, which worked for the most part because during the situation, everyone was afraid of the undead. Those who had different intentions and wanted to seek out the light were usually recruited into the ranks by Dathrohan, who was previously a paladin of the Silver Hand, or High Lord Mograin. And Isilion, the least sane one of them in my opinion, generally tried to use the paranoia of the populace. He even stabbed one of his own attendants to death. When he was asked about it, he said that the attendant was already dead and sent as an assassin by the Forsaken. Now everyone thought that the undead could look just as alive as any of the humans did. So the Scarlet Crusade quarantined the rest of the population of Lordaeron until they were given a bill that said they were clean and healthy. Now to them, anyone could be the enemy. Anyone could be the undead. The odd thing is, although Isilion probably didn't know it at the time, he wasn't wrong. Dathrohan had already been dead for a long time. A veteran of the Legion from the Third War named Balnazar possessed his corpse to manipulate the rest of the population. Using Dathrohan, he was able to manipulate the Scarlet Crusade to his will. Now, the Burning Legion had their own problems with the Scourge, so he was basically just using the humans in the Crusade as a tool to help destroy them. High General Abendus ended up getting killed by the Forsaken, and his daughter stepped up to take his position as High General. She was a very powerful warrior, and now, she was the new High General Abendus. The Scarlet Crusade ended up acquiring different strongholds outside of the monastery. They went to the Plaguelands and captured Hearthglen and Tyr's Hand. They also attempted to invade Northrend, and it was almost a complete failure. They made it to Icecrown, but ended up getting stopped at the glacier. Those who were there were never heard from again. While all of that happens, Dathrohan, or rather his controller Balnazar, convinces Mograin's son, who is named Renault Mograin, that the Ashbringer needs to be destroyed. So Renault took his father and his companions and they assaulted Stratholme, which was obviously a trap. Balnazar told Kel'Thuzad and his minions about what was going to take place, but still the High Lord was actually winning the battle. But then his own son stabbed him in the back with the Ashbringer. High Lord Mograin's healer, High Inquisitor Fairbanks, was already all but killed during the battle. He was completely unable to move to save him. Once he was no longer incapacitated, he ran back to the Scarlet Monastery and informed everyone about what Renault did, but a lot of them thought he was just going insane. And at the end, Fairbanks was murdered and tossed in a closet within the cathedral. High Lord Mograin was then risen as a Death Knight, and the Ashbringer became corrupted. And when you collect the Ashbringer and return to the monastery with it, you're labeled as the new Ashbringer. But the first Mograin kills his son with the corrupted Ashbringer out of revenge, and then resurrects Fairbanks. There were some members of the Scarlet Crusade that left when they heard about Mograin's betrayal, and they became the Argent Dawn. Their overall goal was basically the same, but they wanted to achieve it in the way they believed the Scarlet Crusade should have done. The Argent Dawn accepted all races into their ranks, including some undead, and they wanted to destroy anything evil in Azeroth altogether, so not just exclusively the Scourge. Some members of the Scarlet Crusade were sent to Light's Hope Chapel, which is the stronghold for the Argent Dawn, and they were to fight as allies. The Argent Dawn didn't want to do this, but it was necessary to fight the Scourge. Like the saying goes, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. The representative that was sent to Light's Hope Chapel was named Scarlet Commander Marjan, and we don't know for sure who sent him, but it doesn't look like it was Balthazar. When Abendus died and his daughter became the new High Lord Abendus, Tyrion Fordring's son, named Talon Fordring, was also promoted and became the High Lord of the Scarlet Crusade. His father ended up showing him what was wrong with the Crusade, and Talon realized what he'd been doing wrong. He abandoned the Crusade and escaped from Hearthglen, and ended up getting killed by Ascilian, who was the one who originally recruited him. Tyrion then killed Ascilian out of vengeance, but from then on, struggled with being able to forgive himself and blaming himself for his son's death. Tyrion then swore he would reform the Silver Hand and kill the Lich King. And then eventually, a group of heroes, Tyrion and Taranis, destroy Frostmourne, and all the souls escaped and immobilized the Lich King while they all beat on him. Arthas tore out his own heart, and Tyrion destroyed it. Later on, Balthazar and Mal'Ganis were eventually exposed. The senior leadership of the Scarlet Crusade was completely evaporated, the Lich King was defeated, and Tyrion Fordring ended up retaking Hearthglen for the Argent Crusade. The Scarlet Crusade became a shadow of its former self. Since there weren't many Scarlet members in the Plaguelands, the Argent Crusade became the main strength in that region. They've surpassed the Scarlet Crusade. At this point, only a few members of the Scarlet Crusade survived and stayed in the Western Plaguelands, like Scarlet Judge, Scarlet Smith, and the Scarlet High Clerist. The Crusade completely lost Strathholm because Balthazar came out and killed the remaining Scarlet Crusade members within the city. Balthazar resurrected them with his powers and they became the Risen. Nobody knows exactly how, but the same thing happened to the Scarlet Crusade in Tyr's Hand. The Scarlet Crusade moved to the west of Suladin Farmstead in a new area that was called the Scarlet Palisade, and they were able to keep the Scarlet Monastery under their control. The Trissful Glades is the last place that the Scarlet Crusade is active in. The Scarlet Crusade stayed active in Trissful Glades and began to rebuild their ranks. New members were given ranks to lead the Scarlet members inside the monastery, with one surviving member of the former leadership, Sally Whitemane, the High Inquisitor of the Scarlet Crusade, along with Commander Durand, and he was the one who replaced Renault Mograine as the Scarlet Commander. The Scarlets were ashamed of their past, and the destruction brought on by Balthazar and the Plaguelands and Mal'Ganis and Northrend. So they ordered the new lead mage and archivist, Flameweaver Kogler, to burn any evidence of the history. Lillian Voss said the only way to eliminate the Crusade is to kill Whitemane, which can only be done by stabbing her with the Blades of the Anointed, or else she'll keep coming back. Lillian and the Heroes of the Horde and the Alliance entered the monastery and killed a lot of the remaining forces, along with Sally. After this, some of the surviving members went into hiding, and some of the others started to regroup and retake the monastery. Much later on, the Knights of the Ebon Blade assaulted the Scarlet Monastery, now led by High Commander Goodchild, because they wanted to resurrect Whitemane as a member of their new Four Horsemen. Currently, the Scarlet Onslaught and New Hearthglen appear to still be alive after the death of their leaders. A few of the former Crusaders joined the ranks of the Conclave, and there were some Crimson Pilgrims that showed up in Dalaran. Alright guys, thanks for watching, but that's about all the information we have on the Scarlet Crusade so far. I'm surprised they even keep them around anymore, honestly, but I have to admit, they're good at hanging on to existence by a thread. But thanks for watching again, please give me any feedback in the comments, and if you enjoyed, feel free to like and subscribe. See you next time.